Hello, hello everybody. Been a long time, Maeglin here. Yeah, I haven't posted any videos for about 5 months. Didn't have enough time, guys. I'm so sorry about that. But let's not focus on the past, let's focus on the present. And here I've got for you guys a 3 versus 3 match. It was played a long time ago. Of course, I am playing in this match. This is how I know it was a great match. So we've got familiar players, but we've changed the nicknames a bit. So let me explain you who everyone is. I'm spawning as Fabio Cannavaro on the bottom right corner of the map as men, and my teammate is Predator here as Alessandro Nesta. This is his nickname for this game. Spawning as Isengard in the middle right corner of the map, middle side of the map, and on the top right corner we've got Executor. Executor is Blinky, or some of you might know him as Lazar from some of my previous replays. He's spawning as dwarves, and let's see our opponents. Our opponents are the NWA clan. It was around for like 5 or 6 months ago. I'm not sure if they still exist with this particular name. But let's see, we've got Silencer, I believe here. Silencer is Shogun. He's spawning as Isengard. In the middle, we've got Scarecrow. Scarecrow. Some of you might know him as King JR from the past, and he's spawning as dwarves. And on the bottom left corner of the map, we've got. I'm not sure how this guy's nickname is, but I'm pretty sure that this is Ahmed. Ahmed is most of you might know him as Daniel Day-Lewis or Day-Lewis or something similar to that. All three of our opponents are very experienced. Ahmed here is Elves. And let's see. First moves of the game, you can see. Scarecrow here is pushing in with his Gloin on my fortress. Of course, a wise choice. Although, I'm not sure. Yep, those guys must have used the badge to see what armies we are. And of course, men is the best choice to attack when you are dwarves. Those guys know that. And of course, they are coming in with very aggressively with Gloin, 2 units of Spearmen, 1 unit of Guardians. His Ahmed's Thranduil is here. Causing major damage to my units. You can see I was rushing for cavalry, so I don't have many units myself. My Theoden is here to provide some leadership, but Gloin here is the major concern for me. You can see I'm trying to build some wall hubs. Predator is coming in with his Lurge to give me some cover. His Lurge is level 3. Here comes my hill structure. I'm not sure if it was my hill structure or perhaps Blinky's hill structure. Yep, it was Blinky's hill structure. I haven't used mine yet. Gonna use it really soon, I think. Here it goes. And let's see if we will manage to sustain all this pressure by those guys. You can see they have used the hill on Gloin already. And don't think we can manage to kill Gloin before they take down my fortress, of course. Very nice push by those guys. And major disadvantage here was the fact that I was rushing cavalry. If I knew those guys were coming in with Gloin and so many infantry units, of course I would have chosen to push with infantry. In the meantime, Blinky is pushing in on Scarecrow's fortress. He knows Scarecrow is pushing in on my corner, so instead of Blinky coming in and help defending, he decides to do something very wise to attack with his Gloin. Of course, when you are dwarves, you don't want to spend much time defending your teammates. You want to play as much aggressively as you can, and of course I think he will have no trouble here taking down Scarecrow's fortress. I'm not sure if those guys have used the rebuild already. Don't think so. I think perhaps a heal was used on Gloin already. Blinky, of course, here gonna lose his Gloin, but doesn't matter. He has managed to take down one of our opponent's fortress. You can see I've got a barrack over here. I've got a builder. I'm not sure how much I can do over here. You can see Ahmed is putting a lot of pressure on Predator at the moment since he knows I don't have anything on the bottom corner of the map besides farms. I think this is my only barrack over here. Perhaps my only builder. I'm not sure if I have another one. But let's see how Scarecrow is doing. Scarecrow got, I think, two of his builders at the moment. Predator is deciding, has decided to push on Deilu's fort at the moment. He has Lurch. He has three units of Spearmen, one unit of Swordmen. I'm coming in with my one unit of Rohirrim to help him out. Nice push here by Predator, with not a lot of units. He's managing to cause major damage to Deilu's, and good position on Deilu's here fort. Unfortunately, Lurch's carnage is running out here. I think Deilu's is gonna save his fort. Let's see what we've got. I think we've got a push here on the top corner on Blinky's fortress. I see some of Shogun's units here. Perhaps Lurch was here as well. I'm not sure. I think this is Lurch. Yep, this is Shogun's Lurch. So a push was attempted there by Shogun. Oh, and Ahmed Thranduil here is already level 7. Very good for Ahmed leveling up his heroes. Heroes are gonna help a lot during this part of the game. I mean, basically, when you are facing Isengard, if you have your Thranduil level 7, you are not worried about Lurch so much. I mean, your opponent would have to have Lurch along with at least 3 or 4 units of infantry to kill your Thranduil, cripple him and then kill him, of course. But Lurch alone can no longer kill your Thranduil. You can use your Deadeye, his level 7 skill, and kill Lurch, of course. Nice catch here by Predator. He's managing to kill Shogun's Lurch. You can see I don't have many options over here. I'm trying to spread out my farms across the map. I'm not sure where my last builder is, but I'm spamming as many units as I can over here with my one bark. I think perhaps. Oh, yep, here is my last builder, and you can see how cleverly Ahmed is moving in. He's Thranduil sneaky. He's trying to catch my Thranduil, but my last builder over here. But I wanna try to build something, and Predator comes here with his Lurch. But you can see what I was saying about Thranduil level 7. With his Deadeye, he's not allowing Lurch to come and finish the job. He has to use his units alone. Units without a rallying call cannot do much damage to Thranduil. I want to get my builder out of here as fast as I can before Thranduil gets back here and can kill my builder. Here comes a battle wagon by Scarecrow. A nice play, of course. When you are dwarves and you have lost your fortress, you wanna pressure your opponents as much as you can with battle wagons. Infantry units are too slow for that. Scarecrow knows that, and he's using his battle wagons wisely. Now you can see here I'm making a a tower in order to place my builder inside that tower and maybe protect him. But unfortunately, here you can see Scarecrow's battle wagon, how useful that battle wagon was. Comes in, kills my last builder, and of course is taking me out of the game. I only have one barrack over here left, I think. Don't have anything else on the map right now. Very nice play by Scarecrow, and of course I was afraid that Thranduil was gonna get my builder, but it turns out that Scarecrow's battle wagons were devastating for me. Of course, in the meantime, I was trying to put some pressure with my infantry units, but most of the job is done, as you can see here, by Predator and his units. You can see how spread out Predator's units are. He's trying to take down any farms by our opponents. Blinky so far is trying to spread out his farms across the map so he can move quickly, since he's playing with infantry. But yeah, at the moment it's pretty stable things. We don't have much actions. Most of our all of the players in this game are regrouping at the moment, trying to gather some army and maybe decide to attack. I think the first action is gonna be from Predator over here. You can see he has 4 units of spearmen and 5 units of spearmen actually. He's got his lurch. And let's see. Shogun over here has decided to attack with his lairds, 1 unit of spearmen, 3 berserkers, and of course Scarecrow is bringing in one of his battle wagons. But remember, a glow excuse me Lazar over here has his fortress upgraded, and he has 2 of his heroes. He now has King Dane and Gloin. I think he has his hill structure. Here it goes. I think he's gonna be fine. I think he also summoned his hobbits, his 10 power point. Yep, here it is. So nice defense here by Lazar. And I think in the meantime, yep, Predator was moving in with his forces on the bottom. You heard me saying earlier that we're gonna have definitely some action here by Predator. 5 units of spearmen is a large force, and he had no trouble taking down taking down Ahmed's fortress. And I'm not sure, but perhaps some of his, maybe he caught one of his builders as well. You can see here I'm out of the game. I lost my last barrack over here by let's see, what's that? I think it's Shogun's Wildmen of Dunland. And in the meantime, a battle wagon from Scarecrow is over here on Predator's fortress, and also his Ahmed's Thranduil, his level 7 Thranduil. So a very strong attack here. Lazarin is coming in with his Gloin, trying to help out, but I think it's already too late. Very nice position on Predator's fortress. Perhaps if Predator had seen those wild men of Dunlat earlier and maybe built some wall hubs around his fortress, maybe then he would have a chance to get back. Oh, and the Predator, as I can see here, he's building a builder, so perhaps those are the last. The Predator doesn't have any builders at all at the moment. I'm not quite sure. Oh, let's see. I think it would be a major mistake here if Ahmed would lose his Thranduil, of course, when he has lost his fortress. Here comes Predator's builder. I think it's his last builder. I don't think he has any other builders across the map. So, yeah, a very close save here. You can see Predator is starting a second builder right away. And let's see, in the meantime, Predator is pushing in on Shogun's fortress right now. Remember Scarecrow and Ahmed don't have a fortress at the moment, but they are still in the game, so they have some builders across the map. Let's see how Predator will do here in this small push. I think Blinky is preparing for a large push with his units. Remember, he has Gloin, he has King Dane. He's getting ready. He's gonna be ready soon. I think Predator here has no chance on saving his fortress. I mean, it's gonna go down eventually. You can see Ahmed's Thranduil is level 7. He's gonna use his Deadeye on the fortress. There it goes. Fortress going down. Thranduil grabbing the nice experience and reaching level 10. Ahmed also has a Glorfindel at level 5, so that's gonna be really useful. And let's see, I think Blinky is gonna move in. He knows time is pressuring. Since now, with Predator not having a fortress, I would say this game is pretty much balanced. But remember, I am out of the game, so it's actually a 3 versus 2 at the moment. So Blinky knows he's gotta move in with his units. I'm not sure. I think, yep, Predator has a barrack over here. One of his builders is here. Perhaps the other one is on the top side near Blinky's fortress. I'm not sure. You're watching a nice army management here by Blinky. He's using his units to protect his heroes. Remember, Shogun has a lot of berserkers. I'm trying to find out where Predator's builders are. I think he's in a lot of trouble because I think Ahmed knows that Predator's last builder. Yep, here is Predator's last builder. Oh, and Battle Wagon is coming in from Scarecrow. I think perhaps he has seen Predator's builder. Yep, he has seen Predator's builder and he's coming in for the kill. Oh, nice catch here by Scarecrow. He's catching Predator's last builder. I think with this barrack we're gonna see Predator out of the game. Let's see, it's gonna be really interesting. Yep, Predator has been defeated. Nice catch here by Scarecrow. Remember, Scarecrow, after he lost his fortress, he didn't harass his opponents at all. He only made battle wagons and, of course, was the most important player of this match because he single-handedly took two players out of the game. I mean, took their builders out of the game, and by killing their builders, of course, then enabling his teammates to come and finish their barracks, their last barracks. So excellent play, amazing play here by Scarecrow. But in the meantime, Blinky has a really good position on Shogun's fortress. I mean, he has all those farms over here to upload troops. He's making a barrack. He has a heroic statue. He starts producing more troops. He has his King Dane. All of those troops are here. Here comes his hobbits as well. I think Shogun's fortress is in a lot of trouble here. Maybe not in this push, but in general, this doesn't look very good. All those structures over here. So it's gonna be really interesting, because oh my god, and Blinky's Gloin is level 10. Yeah, I think definitely Blinky's excuse me, Shogun's fortress is going down. Remember, guys, this is a 3 versus 1 match at the moment, so it's gonna be really hard. Even if Blinky has a fortress and all three of his opponents don't have a fortress, remember that Blinky is dwarves, so he can't cover much distance fast. So it's gonna be extremely hard to take out three opponents. You can see here with this is Ahmed had some barracks in the middle. He's got his builder. Shogun is making another barrack elsewhere since he knows he's losing his fortress. Scarecrow, of course, must have some units, some barracks elsewhere as well. Let's see, this is gonna be really interesting. What do you guys think if you have an upgraded fort, two heroes, level 10? Here comes, let's see, here come four units of War Riders by Shogun. Remember, four units of War Riders are really powerful, but I think Blinky perhaps has his rebuild back. Yep. I mean, look at if you have your fort upgraded. Look at how little damage it's taking, and of course with those arrow tower expansions, Blinky has no problem of clearing out all those units. So what I was saying is, what do you guys think? Three versus one. The three players don't have a fortress. The one player has a fortress. Who do you think is gonna win? It's really tough. I mean, if the game started with three players without a fortress attacking one player with a fortress, of course there would be no dispute. I think the three players would have won the game like 9 out of 10 times. But remember that this game isn't like that because it's already in progress. I mean, you can see how many farms those guys have, but it's the only thing they have. Blinky has a lot of units over here. They're moving in. They're gonna clear out all those farms very soon, and you can see he has started making his farms across the map. Let's see, it's gonna be really interesting to see. I think the most important thing here is that Ahmed still has two of his heroes. He's got Glorfindel, he's got Thranduil. Those two heroes can be a really big deal to decide who's gonna win the game. I mean, especially elven heroes in late game are really powerful. Glorfindel can cover much great distances really fast and take down opponent farms, clear out the field. Thranduil can move around and of course at level 10 kill opponent heroes, track down Blinky's builders. But let's see, this is certainly interesting. Oh, and bad play here by Ahmed. He managed to lose his Glorfindel by moving him over some spearmen by Blinky. Those spearmen were level 5, so I mean, Glorfindel on a horse would be taking great damage by spearmen anyway, but those units were level 5, so they were causing extra damage. So nice catch here by Blinky. He managed to take down one of the two heroes that were gonna cause him a lot of trouble during the remains of this match. And let's see, Blinky still has a lot of units on the bottom left corner of the map. He's gonna move in, clear all those structures. Let's see if he's gonna decide to go for the middle or the top right or the bottom right corner of the map. Remember Ahmed's last builder is over here, so I don't think he can catch him with infantry units, but let's see. He's certainly moving in that direction. Oh, here come some of Scarecrow's units, I believe. Those are Scarecrow's units, yep, grey. So they were opponent dwarves attacking Blinky's fortress, and actually they managed to do a lot of damage. But here come the Hobbits again by Blinky. Nice use of the 10 power point. Hobbits certainly have proven useful to Blinky a lot of times when he was defending, but also when he was attacking. And let's see, Blinky decided to split his units. Like I told you, where he was gonna go, he decided to go for both places at the same time. Of course, when you have a lot of units, you can do that. And I'm not sure what exactly happened over here, but Ahmed has been defeated from the game. I think perhaps Blinky was attacking his barracks at the same time, both his barracks in the middle side of the map and at the bottom right corner of the map. So Blinky got really lucky over here. He managed to take down one of his opponents, and most importantly, he managed to take down the hardest of his opponents. Like I told you in the past, elves are like ultra powerful against the dwarves, so basically managing to take down elves, and especially elves when they have two leveled up heroes, it's a great deal over here. I think Blinky's chances of winning the game have increased a lot over here. Remember, only Shogun and Scarecrow left over here. I don't think Scarecrow has a lot of resources, since he was playing with battle wagons. Look at this map, not a lot of structure exists. Blinky controls the inn on the bottom side of the map. Shogun controls the outpost on the top side of the map, so perhaps we will see a fortress from Shogun soon. I think he will have the resources very soon to do so. I don't think Scarecrow gonna have the resources, because like I told you, Scarecrow was playing with battle wagons. Battle wagons are extremely costful, and you have to upgrade them to banner carriers in order to be able to do some damage. So that's more money you have to spend in order to play aggressively. But like I told you, Scarecrow, I mean, we haven't seen a lot of Scarecrow during this match, but I definitely believe that he is the top and key player of this match, because he managed to kill the last builder from me and also the last builder from Predator with a single battle wagon. So let's see, I believe that those are nobody's units, probably some kind of bug or something. And I think, Blinky still has a lot of infantry units. Of course, he can use them to destroy some of the of his opponent's buildings, but I think he definitely needs to start producing some battle wagons himself in order to cover some distance faster. I mean, look at how good battle wagons turn out to be for Scarecrow. Now it's Blinky's chance to do the same to those guys. And of course, only way to do that is with him playing with battle wagons, I think. I mean, he has some leveled up heroes he can remake from his fortress. But as long as his opponents don't have a fortress... Oh, okay, Shogun already has a fortress on the top left side of the map. That's what I was gonna say. I mean, if your opponent don't have a fortress, no point on playing with heroes. If you are dwarves, you wanna play with battle wagons, destroy his farms, his resources. really fast and then go for the kill, destroy his barracks. But now that Shogun has a fortress, things change up a bit. I think still, even with Shogun having a fortress, I think Blinky has the upper hand in this game, because you can see his fortress is upgraded. He has all those arrow tower expansions, so he's not worried about his fortress anymore, I think. So it's gonna be really who, and let's see. Blinky here finds out about Shogun's new fortress. Let's see what his plans are about this. We're seeing a rather odd choice of PowerPoints by Blinky. Don't know if you guys remember my Dwarven tutorial. I almost never use hobbits when I am dwarves. I mean, I almost never use them, whatever I am, even if I am elves or something. So after that, Blinky has decided to go for the lone tower, a PowerPoint that I'm also never using, but perhaps he went that way because he wanted to get the Undermine. I'm not sure. Undermine can be extremely helpful, especially in late game, but I don't like the fact that I have to use the Summon of Hobbits and the lone tower in order to get the Undermine. So this is why I almost never go that way. I go the other and choose the Dwarven Riches that give me extra resources, and of course the Baraz. But let's see. I think Blinky gonna get ready for a major push here on Shogun's fortress. Actually, Blinky is getting very close to his 25 PowerPoint. And also, Shogun is getting very close to his 25 PowerPoint. This is gonna be really interesting. Remember, the guy that will reach the 25 PowerPoint first will have a greater advantage on attacking his opponent's base, because Shogun now has his Lurch back. He can start creating some units, and after that he has the force along with some of his power points to pose a threat to Blinky's base, because at the moment nothing that those guys have can cause major damage to Blinky's base, especially if he uses his rebuild. So I still think, okay, Shogun has upgraded his fortress as well, so I think it's now a pretty even match, I would say. I think perhaps we're waiting to see. I think Blinky might be waiting for some of his heroes to get back, because he knows he's gonna need a lot of units to attack Shogun's base. Here, Blinky here uses his Undermine poorly, in my opinion. He's using it as a defensive PowerPoint, but Undermine is like the most powerful offensive power point. And I think Blinky right now is getting a lot of pressure from his opponents. He doesn't have a lot of structures, if he doesn't have any at all, except his fortress and this lonely farm over here. Okay, he has another farm on the bottom. This is really helpful because he can simply place one of his builders inside here. Get him out on this end and then start creating more farms on this side of the map or something. I think yep, Blinky already got his Glowing back. I think he's gonna wait to get Dane back as well, and then I think he's gonna try and attack against Shogun's base. Look at how nice Scarecrow is moving in with his wagons again, taking down some of Blinky's last structures. I'm not. Oh, okay. And things are starting to look different for the NWA clan. Scarecrow is making a new fortress. This is a game changer over here, because if Scarecrow is able to use some of his power points again, then we're looking at a huge difference. Let's see. I think the difference is gonna be who is gonna have his 25 power point first. Shogun, he's currently 23, or Blinky, he's 23 as well, closing in on his 24th power point. But I don't think maybe okay, Blinky here is making some a farm. He's trying to move. Okay, no, he's lost his builder. Oh my god, and he exited some of his units, losing his guardians instantly here by Scarecrow's battle wagons. Blinky here gonna have to withdraw a bit. You can see he almost have his 25 power point. I mean, if he had his 25 power point, he would certainly choose. I'm not sure if he can choose that. Yeah, he has got the cloud break, so he definitely can choose the earthquake. Use the earthquake over here in that area and damage both fortresses instantly, and after that, along with his glowing level 10 and his King Dane, he can easily take down at least Scarecrow's fortress. Maybe then move in for Shogun's fortress. But remember, Shogun is also very close to his 25 power point as well. I mean, he could easily get the dragon and then go kill any heroes that are attacking his base. Okay, you can see Blinky has reached his 25 power point. You can see he's thinking the same way that I am thinking. Earthquake, preferably in that area over here. Then move in with his heroes and take down the rest. Let's see, this is gonna be really interesting. I think we are waiting on Blinky's Dane to come help his glowing. Oh, let's see, Shogun here is moving in with his alerts. Blinky needs to get his glowing out of defensive stance. I think he's gonna lose him over here. Yeah, nice play by Shogun, crippling and killing here his glowing. Shogun is making up. You can see here. You can see here. Blinky was waiting for his Dane to come. Yeah, I think definitely this game is looking good for Shogun and Scarecrow at the moment. But perhaps if Blinky's Dane had come like 1 or 2 minutes earlier, then we would be looking at a totally different match. Here comes Shogun's 25 PowerPoint. Of course, it will be the dragon to destroy all those towers around Blinky's fortress. Here come some of Blinky's power points to help him defend. Yep, and I think this is a game over. But a really nice fight by Blinky over here. You could see how single-handedly he took out one of his opponents and almost destroyed the other two. I mean, it was really close. But yeah, eventually it's really hard to play against three and even two opponents. So this is the match I wanted to show to you guys. Thank you all very much for watching, and I don't know, I haven't even started on the Isengard tutorial yet. I know some of you guys were asking about this. I haven't even started yet, but I think I'm gonna start pretty soon, and of course release it somewhere. I don't know, I'm not gonna make any more estimates on when I will release it, so I don't lie to you guys again. But I can promise you this, I will release it, I only don't know when exactly I will. But yeah, besides the tutorial, I might show you guys some more videos of Battle for Middle-earth soon. Again, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you around. Bye bye.